Welcome to Popternative, where we dive into topical discussions from the worlds of pop culture, social media, and sports. Here is your host, Peter Remoliotis, a.k.a. PD Beats.
Hello and welcome to the Popternative Podcast, the podcast and talk show where we have digital discussions, the worlds of sports, TV, film, news, music, everything really depending on the guests, talk about it all. As always, I'm your host, Peter Remoliotis. On social media, you know me as PD Beats. The Mighty Ducks Game Changers will be dropping March 26th on Disney Plus, and we are speaking to someone who you will soon recognize from the series. We are speaking to Julie Serda. Julie, welcome to Popternative.
Hey, hey!
Thank you so much for doing this.
Yeah, man. Thanks for having me.
I told you before we started, I am from Canada, so hockey's always been a big deal. The Mighty Ducks is like one of those franchises that is very close to my heart. I mean, has it hit you that you are going to be part, whether people know about the franchise before they signed on? I mean, you are part of an iconic sports franchise. How does that feel?
Yeah. I mean, it feels pretty amazing, you know? I'm not from Canada, so I'm not like a hockey fanatic like everybody that I know from there, but I mean, I grew up watching the Mighty Kids. The Mighty Kids came out when the Mighty Ducks came out when I was a kid, you know. And I just remember watching the movie and quacking around the house with my little brother, driving my mom insane. I gotta say it's pretty exciting. I remember like when my agents talked to me about the role and the series, I was totally playing it cool, you know, like just that's good. But deep down, so I was like, oh my god, the Mighty Ducks. It's so exciting.
It is so exciting. And it's interesting because I find a lot of, you can say this about a lot of like sports movies and TV shows. There's like the sports aspect of it. And then there's the relationships and things that happen in the storyline aspect of it. Right.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's interesting how these shows become like two shows because people enjoy the sports aspect of it, but then they enjoy the character growth as well.
Yeah. Of course. Always. I mean, I think that's what makes sports movies so great, you know?
Absolutely. No, for sure. I mean, it's pretty crazy because, okay, so it drops March 26th. People kind of see you in the trailer because the trailer dropped and people like lost their minds because it has such a nostalgic feel and it looks a lot like the old Mighty Ducks movies, which is pretty crazy as well.
Well, I mean, I think, you know, Stephen Brill is the original creator of the Mighty Ducks. He's still involved. He's heavily involved with the show. So, yeah, it's going to have a lot of that that nostalgia that we all experience when we watch the film. It's going to be there. So, you know, it happens 20 years later and it's a whole new world. You know, the Mighty Ducks isn't what it was once in the movie. In the series, the Mighty Ducks, you know, they are like the ultimate super competitive youth hockey team, you know, with state-of-the-art facilities, corporate sponsorships, and basically anything that money can buy.
Exactly.
You know, to create like an all-star winning team. So it's going to be a huge diversion and a shock. But you're going to still get that Mighty Duck story, you know, where the underdogs come into play and, you know, and it's going to be about hope, determination, and this can do. So it's going to be really touching, I think.
I'm trying to like keep it in because I am a big hockey guy and a lot of things, there's a lot of things that are addressed in the trailer and throughout the show about what hockey has become. And I find that's an important thing as well. Like it's addressed a little bit in the pilot too about, you know, how like insane it's become and how like serious people are taking it. Like the parents are taking it very seriously. You're taking it very seriously.
Absolutely. And also, you know, my character, Stephanie, she's a mom of one of the Mighty Ducks team members. And so it also really relates to a lot what's happening like on for the children and how we're preparing them and grooming them for this world. So it's kind of a bit scary, I gotta say.
Absolutely.
I'm sure we've all kind of experienced that one way or another.
It's interesting too about the developments of characters. Now people saw that, you know, Emilio Estevez is coming back as Goran Bombay and everyone was very excited about it. You see him in the trailer, so it's not really a spoiler, but obviously something happened in his career because we saw him at the end of Mighty Ducks 3 and, you know, he becomes a big executive for USA Hockey and everything. Yeah. And then still helps them out with the lawyer, but he's not coaching Ian Hall. So it seemed like everything was going well and he was involved with hockey. People watched the trailer, right? He runs the Ice Palace. He's not happy about hockey. Yeah. He doesn't want to be involved. So don't you find that's kind of interesting too? I mean, you guys went in and like you're like Stephen Brill, they're putting together this story and everything. I mean, you go 20 years later, I mean, so many things can happen. Like, the possibilities are endless.
A lifetime happens in 20 years. Yeah. So it's not shocking that something like that could happen, you know, to a character like Gordon Bombay. And so, you know, I think it's great. I mean, it's a fantastic world and everything goes according to plan. But the reality is, life doesn't go according to plan. So it doesn't shock me that Gordon Bombay wants nothing to do with this and has just removed himself from the world of hockey completely.
Absolutely. There's a lot of characters like yourself that are new characters to Mighty Ducks Game Changers. Yourself, Coach T, played by Dylan Playfair, new characters. It's bringing back old characters as well, like Emilio Estevez, Gordon Bombay. Cobra Kai, which was on Netflix, had an amazing reception with the fact that they were blending new characters and old characters from the old Karate Kid movies. Is it safe to say that it excites you as a storyteller to see that this can happen for the Mighty Ducks, the blending of the new and the old characters?
Absolutely. I mean, I think when we all watched the Mighty Ducks film, you know, we all fell in love with Charlie Conway and the gang. I mean, those were our friends, you know, as viewers. And so I think at first it's going to be kind of hard and shocking. Be like, well, it's not going to be the same, but it is. I mean, you're going to fall in love with a whole new team. These kids are amazing. They're adorable. I mean, they're going to steal your hearts in the same way that Charlie Conway and the gang did. So, yeah, it's interesting that we can take a story and take these characters and introduce new ones and just tell the same story in a different way.
How are you preparing for a role like this? Like, we don't know much about your character, but we know, we see you in the trailer, people kind of read about it. You're going to be around, and you're involved, you know, as a parent for your daughters on the Mighty Ducks. I mean, but like, how do you prepare for a role like this where it seems it's going to be like a growth for your character? It's gonna be ups and downs. Like, are you are you an antagonist? Are you a protagonist? Are you down the middle? Like, we don't know. Like, it might be a roller coaster emotionally to prepare for a role like that.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, I think people are gonna love hate my character. I mean, she's definitely an antagonist in the story. I mean, she's one of the moms of the super competitive sport. So naturally, with this team, you know, you're gonna get the highly competitive, you know, parents who are under the pressures of success. And so you're gonna see that world and how it infiltrates, you know, youth sports as a whole. And then also, I mean, what's interesting about my character is that I also play Alex's boss, who's played by Lauren Graham. Yes. So I'm a super successful, high-powered attorney, you know? And so this idea of succeeding is just my world. And I think it plays a great juxtaposition in contrast with Alex's character, who's more laid back and, yeah, life is like, we can make this happen kind of attitude. So it's going to be funny. In my opinion, whenever I read the script, I was always laughing because it's so real in a sense that, you know, when Alex and Stephanie get together, it's just complete awkwardness between the two because they're so different.
It is.
Like, it's totally different. You know, there's a whole lot of like passive aggressive. Did she just say that? I don't know. Did she just say that? Well, I did just say that, you know, kind of thing that happens. And I think everybody can relate to that.
I feel like your character is like, you mentioned, it's funny because you mentioned, and you even see it a little bit like in the trailer, your character is like, I don't think you're deep down, your character doesn't think she's being like rude. That's just how.
No, never.
It's
no.
Like naive a little bit. Yeah.
Desperately to be like Alex's best friend. And, you know, and I think that's what makes her endearing and funny in a way. You know, I really love this character. So it doesn't take a lot to prep for it in the sense that it's just, you know, just play her real. And like she has a heart. It's just completely misunderstood.
Oh, no, for sure. Absolutely. It's interesting as well because, well, the little Easter eggs, I mean, you guys are attorneys. I mean, what did Gordon Bombay do in the first Mighty Ducks movie? Right. Yeah. I mean, that's awesome. You know what I mean? Man, I went back and I rewatched all the movies cause they're on Disney Plus and I can watch them all. People can watch all the Mighty Ducks movies. Before you watch Mighty Ducks Game Changers, go back and rewatch them because I had a blast doing that. But like, he's very, he grows, but he is like not a happy camper in the first movie.
Oh, no.
Like,
no.
There's one line. That, you know, when you ever go back, Julie, really, and watch stuff that you forget lines from?
Yeah,
like,
yeah, of course.
Yeah, there's one where he's like, when he first meets them, when he drives when they're on like the outdoor ice rink and he meets the team for the first time and he's like, all right, scrimmage, you versus you. And they're like, you know, we have names, you know. And he's like, I'm sure you do. I bet they're really great ones. So yeah. Great, I might actually learn them one day.
Yeah, I know. It's a good line. It's really funny. Yeah.
But it's interesting. When people kind of watch this, you talked about it a little bit. I mean, there's good character dynamics between, you know, your character and Graham's character, and there's like the nostalgia. Diving a little bit deeper into it, what are you hoping people get out of it when they watch The Mighty Ducks Game Changers, Julie?
Gosh, you know, I mean, honestly, considering the world that we live in today, you know, with this pandemic, which everyone's just so tired of, and then recent elections, and it's just, I feel like there's just been such a damper in the world mm-hmm. lately. And so, like, I just really hope people can just watch this as a way to escape and just, you know, just see that there is a little bit of lighthearted love and fun out there in the world, because there are beautiful stories like that, you know, that aren't just so doom and gloom every day. And it's going to be great because it'll be something that parents can really, truly enjoy with their children, too. So really do people have an opportunity to use that time to get away and enjoy with the family.
Absolutely. You mentioned a little bit, too. You were a fan of the Mighty Ducks movies when you were growing up. Yeah. I know you can't fully speak for everyone in the cast and crew, but was there a lot of like researching and a lot of going back and watching the movies and going back to the nostalgia when you guys were making this?
You know, I think everyone... from what I know, everyone had seen the film, yeah. You know, and not because we were doing the project, but because it's just, you know, it's part of our culture. It's
absolutely.
Just it's something that everyone had already known about. So I don't think that there was a lot of going back, you know, because it's a whole new fresh story, too. So I think everyone wanted to just bring the themes, the sentiments, they're all there.
You Are know? You prepared for the abundance of fan theories that are going to happen?
Fan what?
Theories.
Oh, fan
There's
theories.
There's going to be so many fan theories about
I
everything.
Love them.
I know,
yeah.
But they become overwhelming sometimes because not everyone. But the
it's
thing
such
is,
an incredible
mind. Everyone's going to be like, this character is related to this character from the Mighty Ducks. And it's like, everyone
yeah,
can't
oh my God,
be related to everyone.
Yeah. Look, they're wearing the same shirt. Yeah, totally.
Yeah, it's going to be crazy.
I'm glad you brought that up. I'm going to be totally looking out for those.
It's going to be crazy. There's going to be so many fan theories because there's so many old characters on the Mighty Ducks, right? Because a lot of players, there's going to be like, she's the end of this player.
That was exactly. Yeah.
What were some learning experiences for you working on this as not only about like maybe working on a sports project, but anytime you work on a project, there's going to be learning experiences. What were kind of your learning experiences, learning curves for you on Mighty Ducks Game Changers?
Well, without giving too much away, I did have to get into skates for an episode. Mm-hmm. And I learned that no matter how fit, how athletic, how determined you are, hockey skates hurt like a mother. Oh my God. I just don't know how people do it. And my feet were certainly like not meant to be in this.
Well, no, I think that was that like your first time putting skates on?
Like real hockey. I put on hockey skates?
No, but that's normal. The first time you put on real hockey skates, it's like, oh my God.
Holy cow.
Yeah, it's a thing.
Not expecting that.
No, it's a thing. If you wore them like more, like you'd get used to them, but like that's
I
a
know,
thing.
I don't know how I can get used to them. I'm pretty convinced that it's
crazy. But Julie, thank you so much for coming on the show. I really appreciate you taking the time.
Awesome. It was great chatting with you.
So March 26th, they're going to be able to watch the Mighty Ducks Game Changers on Disney Plus. I mean, has it hit you that it's on the way? Like, it's crazy.
Yeah, I've been waiting for it. So it's going to be exciting. I'm so looking forward to it.
Absolutely. Where can people follow you on social media to keep up to date with everything?
You can follow me in Julie Serta. You just type in my name and you'll find me.
Amazing.
I'm on Instagram, Twitter.
Julie with two E's, though.
Julie with two E's. Yeah.
Absolutely. Well, this has been PopTurnative, youtube.com/PopTurnative for previous episodes. Please look out for Mighty Ducks, the Game Changers, coming on March 26th on Disney Plus. Until next time, this is Julia Serta and PD Beats.
Bye.
Signing off.
Thank you for tuning in to PopTurnative. Make sure to check out our past episodes of PopTurnative on YouTube. Be sure to like PopTurnative on Facebook and follow us on Twitter.
This has been an Autograph Communications production.